things that you seek for and you yearn for and the things that you desire within yourself, God will start revealing it to you. He'll start revealing dreams and desires, and he'll start opening up doors. Why? Because you line your life, your household, and everything that's attached to you to God. I come out here to tell single women, if you get in church, if he really likes you, all of a sudden you'll see him sitting on the pew. He may not wave his hands, stomp his feet, or say nothing, but if he really likes you, he'll be in church.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes. Yes. If he really likes you, he'll be in church. And that's why so many men, that's why so many bad men and polluted men are out there, because the women that they like is not stepping up to the plate. Attracted to women by nature. So if that woman go to church, I'm going too, if I like it. Now if I don't like it, I ain't gonna go. I rebel, I make excuses, I say, oh, well, I got, you know, grandma coming by here, my auntie in town, and so-and-so just flew in, and every time you turn around, there's an excuse, a dog just died, or we gotta get a new battery in the car, and this and alternator, and we ain't got no groceries, and man, we lost his shoes this morning, and I ain't got no bills, and I ain't got no but two more diapers, and it'll be full of excuses. But if he really like you, come hell or high water, I don't care if you gotta get on the bus and stand in the hot sun and hold them kids together. He'll be on the bus too and say, we going to church and we gonna get some transfer so we can go back home.
Yeah.
See, if we really start attacking the issue where they are at. See, so many men won't be the way they are. See, so many people give men freedom from experience. They give men freedom. They come in and they say, oh, it's fine. You got a girlfriend, it's fine. That's why I just be the person on the side.
No.
Oh, come on. So come on, no, Alan, we've been saved all our life. Yes. I just, you know, child, you know, you hang outside, you call me. You ain't got me, You first of all, then they convince you. You first of all, I hate your woman anyway, you know? So you ain't gotta really put up with me like that. I just wanna kick it a little bit.
Yes.
Now you convinced. Because you've stepped into a new arena that you've never been exposed from. And that's why some good men go bad. I'm going to help you. I'm going to teach you how good men go bad. Because they're exposed to wickedry. Wherefore, if they ain't got Christ, they ain't got nothing to fight off the devil. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
They ain't got nothing to fight off. So if you ain't got nothing to fight with, that's just like being in a battle. You're in a gun battle, you ain't got nothing to fight with. And you going to try to stay in here and counsel this brother? I'll be counseling him from across the street. As I'm walking to the other side, you need to put the gun down. As my feet moving this, you need to put the gun down. I'm going to get some run room. And anytime a man doesn't have Christ in his life, he has nothing. So of course he's going to be corrupt. And all it takes is a corrupt woman to come in his life and expose him to avenues that he's never been exposed to before. Oh, come on, somebody. All it takes is a Delilah. All it takes is one Delilah to come in and he'll share his strength. You know, babe, I really like Maria. And you know his blood pressure is so high, if he licked the sauce off of Maria, he'll almost go into a coma. And you come home and you got ribs, big ribs, salt just running all over the plate, and they're running, and you don't want to count by, you know you did it intentionally. You try to really, he ain't got no faith. Hey, what you going to test? You can't test his faith. He ain't got no faith. What are you going to do with that? No, maybe if I could cut off the corner, you know, it won't be so bad. Then he cut off the corner, then you come home, and he laying on the couch. You don't know if you need to call 911 or go call Mitchell. Why? Because people is so wicked. And all it takes is one. All it takes is one Queen Sheba. Come on, somebody. All it takes is one. See, I tell women, I said, you carry a power that a man doesn't possess. And that's your attraction in the way you make him feel. You see, we gotta go back to scripture. The Bible said a woman's glory is not a man. It's her hair, it's her makeup, it's her beauty. So if a man's glory is a woman, that means if she's making him feel good, that means she almost got power over him.
Yes.
Can convince him to do things and tap into things. And now that's why you got all the swinging going on. The man, he ain't care about no swinging. He would have stayed dedicated. But when you say, come on, baby, let's try something new, he was like, oh, that sounds good. Because you're exposing him to an atmosphere that he's not aware of. And when you start exposing to an atmosphere, and if he ain't got Christ, he ain't got nothing. Yes. Sun and Moon can't stop this. Buddha can't stop this. Leotis and Zoroaster can't stop this. Ben Yahweh can't stop this. Yes. He ain't got nothing to fight with. So of course he's gonna go out there and have 15 girlfriends. Well, he ain't got nothing to fight off the devil with. Then they say, oh, look at him. We ain't got nothing but a bunch of bad men. Of course. Because you got a bunch of bad women in the camp and ain't talking. Some of our best friends were some of the worst people in the street. And we know, we had some buddies in public. You would have thought they were the sweetest and nicest person. You would have thought they were marriage material. Until you really talked to somebody that really knew them, you want to marry who? 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 He be talking to my sister. He trying to get with my sister. Come on, somebody. Don't act like we've been saved that long now.
All right.
And people don't want to deal with the matters of the heart.
Yes.
And when people's heart get polluted and intoxicated with filth and wickedry, they don't have nothing else to turn to. If they ain't got Christ, they don't have anything. That's just like having that's just like drowning and you don't have a life raft. So if nobody's not throwing you that spiritual life raft to pull you out of that deep water, they just gonna keep drowning.
All right.
So that's why they wonder why the crime rate is going up. It's going up because you're giving jobs, but people, even some of the slum kids even know that you can't make it off no $7.50 an hour. With no education, they ain't even graduated from their house university. They know good well that you can't pay a $400 rent, a $100 light bill, and a $50 phone bill, and put a food on the table with $7.50 while people try to tell me, be grateful. You can't be grateful when you're starving and you're on the verge of suicidal thoughts. Why? Because the world is caving in on you.
Yes.
See, people don't want to deal with those issues. You don't hear that from your television evangelist. No, we don't talk about that. Preacher, we talk about that. The Satan will take them way down. I'm going to have to turn in the jet and talk about that. But it's true. And that's why people is not getting delivered. That's why people come to church and we are emotional just by the being natural. All they take is a beat for us and we'll dance, we'll hop. So when we get us catching the Holy Ghost, is no problem to us. So all we gotta do is get on that walk in the super pad and pull back on the keys and the Holy Spirit start flowing. We'll run and the wig fall off and we go to the side and the glasses go everywhere. Cause we are emotional by nature. We are some really blessed people because we're blessed with rhythm.
Yes,
we are. So it don't take much for us to get into the spirit. All you gotta do is get on them drums and get on them instruments, and then all of a sudden we start sliding across the floor. You slide in the club. Don't stop sliding now.
That's right.
Don't stop. Tell my child, you know, I can't slide like I used to. You can do something. I bet you put you in a football game. You can shout in a basketball game. Come on, man. You ain't gonna hit that. Come on. Man, I ain't buying that little ticket. But then you get in church and I'm like, it don't take all that to serve God. It don't take all that. They jumping, acting crazy and stuff. That one going down the street where they start at 11:15 and get out at 12:15. And that way you're in the same boat. Why? Because you got a microwave church with a microwave message. Dog, you need some soul food, some greens, some of that soul food that get down to your spirit. So when you get out of church, you all gonna feel full. You all ain't even hungry no more. You just go home and say, child, you can't even see. You can tell, you know that full feeling. All you can do is say, man, I think I ate too much. I can't even get up from the table. You said the gold corral, the waiter, they done gave you the check, you done tipped the waiter, and they still looking at you, they ask you, do you want something else? Because you done overate, you ought to be the same way in the church. You overeat. You eat so much, child, you know. Well, we going to the restaurant, but give me a minute. I just gotta sit here and just collect all this what I just ate this morning, and we should be that way. But when we come that way, we become hungry and thirsty for righteousness. Therefore, our hearts will be changed. Therefore, what come out of our mouth will be empowerment and will be enlightenment. And that's what the Bible says. We ought to light up darkness. See, when darkness come up, light disappears. If you look outside, you won't see the sun. Come on, somebody. So if we're the light of the world, then we ought to be able to shine. We ought to be able to stand firm, almost like a flower. We ought to be able to stand up and stand out. And when you be able to stand up and stand out, then when the flood come against you, when Satan come against you, you'll have something to fight with.
Yeah.
But in my closing,